This show ought to be on about 10:30 Saturday morning. That's when this show ought to be on. Show some cartoons. We have a clown come out. Get the folks tumbling. Dear Dave, letter number 4 begins. Every weekend for the past month, I have called up each of 3 local rock stations and requested to hear The Sultan of Swing by Dire Straits. They all say they will play it, so I spend up to 4 hours listening to the radio, but they never do play it, at least not while I'm listening. Will you please play The Sultans of Swing on your show and help me get back at those darn DJs? Yours sincerely, Cindy Sherwin, Raleigh, North Carolina. Well, you know, Cindy, I would love to have Paul and the band play The Sultans of Swing for you, but as you know, if you watch the program, the band doesn't play any songs until they're at least 20 years old.
Hold it, Dave.
I don't think that's fair.
Come on, you guys.
What's the matter?
That's it.
Wait a minute, guys. Hold it. Paul, Sid, Will, Anton, Dave. Fudge.
What?
Huh? Come on. Yeah. Here you go.
All right.
This is Fudge. Come on.
Okay.
Yeah, help yourself. There you go, Anton.
Okay. You know, as long as it never happens again.
Yeah, okay. Get some fudge. All right. There you go, boys. Okay. Thank you very much.
Come on.
Yeah, one more. Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah, you bet, guys. About 10:30 in the morning, we'll be sponsored by Flintstones Vitamins and Kool-Aid and that kind of stuff. Mattel will be a big sponsor for the show. Letter number 3. Dear Dave, does Paul serve any particular function on the show?
Just wondering,
Jay Jacobs, Hudson, Ohio. Well, I guess, Paul, Jay, you're being facetious here. He's not only our band leader, Paul, but he's the staff counselor, our handyman and spiritual advisor. And that's about it, isn't it, Paul? You do all of those things? Anything else?
Yeah, that's it. No, there's one function that I really never should have tried to serve.
Well, what is that?
Staff barber.
That does it. Now, there's only so much I can stand.
Now, wait a minute. Now, Paul, see what you've done? You've upset Sid.
Wait a minute. Don't worry. I can handle it. Oh, Sid. Lemonade, Sid.
Yeah. Come back. Sure.
I think maybe I'm going to need some coffee. Okay, letter number 5. Dear Dave, I was in a restaurant the other night and saw a very well-dressed man with a beautiful blonde. Could it have been Paul? Eager to know. Don Sherman, Redondo Beach, California. I don't know, Don. Paul, were you in a restaurant the other night with a beautiful blonde?
Well, I was in a restaurant, but I'm a little concerned about Don Sherman's description of my dinner companion. If I remember correctly, it was after the show one night, and...
Actually, the more I look at it, the more I like it.
So that was probably the evening that Don Sherman was.
Yeah, well, there you go. That's what it is. Sure.
A beautiful blonde. Don Sherman thinks you're a beautiful blonde, Sid. You're beautiful, baby. You're beautiful.
Anton, knock it off, Anton. Don't worry, Sid. It'll grow in a little while. Hey, don't worry. How about a little fudge with that lemonade?
Yes, sir. Okay, kids, welcome to Friday night. Yes. Dear Mr. Letterman, I am sorry to inform you that your show has been canceled. Please leave the NBC stationery when you clean out your desk. Sincerely, Kenny Hobbs, Stanton, Kentucky. Wow, did you hear that, Paul? The show's been canceled. We got to clean out the desks.
Hold it. Wait a second.
The letter said we got to move.
You mean
all of this stuff.
That this is how it all ends? We get canceled and you just clean out your desk like some kind of little wimp? You know something?
Letter comes in.
I've been here 6 years. I don't even have a desk. Let's face it, we've been treated like dirt. Dave, if we're going to leave, let's take a piece of this place with us.
What exactly are you saying, Paul?
I'm saying let's trash this dump.
No, I don't. No, I don't. No, I don't.
Hal. Yes, Hal. Hold it, guys. Yes, Hal. What is it, Hal?
Yeah, Dave, we checked into this Kenny Hobbs guy from Stan, Kentucky.
Right.
He's not with GE or NBC. Looks like some kind of hoax.
Oh. You see that? It's all a misunderstanding.
Oh, gee, I feel terrible.
Yeah, well.
I'm always overreacting, too,
well,
isn't
that right?
It's just a hoax.
Thank God. Thanks,
Never
Anton.
Mind.
All right, enjoy yourself.
I feel silly about it.
That's good. That's, you know, I'm glad we weren't canceled just when we have the fountain working and everything. You know, right now, Paul, we're supposed to do this small town news deal where I show you silly little things from the newspaper. But the truth of the matter is I'm sick and tired of doing small town news. And quite frankly, I got stuff I need to do. So I thought, well, maybe this would be the perfect opportunity to bring in a substitute. To take over and do the small town news for me while I go out and attend to my personal affairs.
You're going to bring in a substitute.
Going to bring in a substitute. Ladies and gentlemen, please say hello to Regis Philbin. Regis, come on in. And Regis, thanks for helping me out. Here's what we're going to do. Just have a seat here. Thank you. This is, I don't know if... I know you get up early, so you've probably never seen it. Small Town News, these are all very funny little items cut out of small town newspapers. The top line there, that's the paper, that's the setup, and that's the punchline. And just do three or four of those. And there's the band, and Paul
Hi, guys.
Will help you.
How
Bill
you doing?
Wendell will
nice
help you.
To see you.
This is the audience. And ladies and
Hi,
gentlemen.
Everybody.
I want you...
Yeah, what a treat. Wow.
I want you all to give Regis the same courtesy while he's here filling in that you give me night after night.
Boy, I like this.
And I'll be right back, Regis. Good luck. And,
okay,
and please,
David.
Be kind to him. Thank you very
hey, David,
much,
David, thanks
I'll
very much
right
for the
back.
Break. Excuse I really appreciate it.
Sure. Good luck. Have fun.
What a wonderful guy. Okay, right.
Yeah.
But first, can I do one of these? Nothing. Thanks a lot. Anyway, here we go, folks, with some small town news now. Here's item number one. And this comes from Hendricks County News, Indiana. This is about the first fire hydrant installed in Liston. Just watch the home prices in this state. They're going to skyrocket. This must be one of the newspapers. Say, excuse me. Please, can I help you a little bit?
Well, we're just, you know, usually around this time of the show, Dave lets us go to the commissary.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Phil, he lets us go.
But I'm sorry, Dave didn't say anything about that. I'm afraid what? You'll have to return to your places like nice boys.
All right. Now, come on, we'll just, you know.
All right. Let's move right on now to item number two.
Oh, yeah.
Here's something from the Tate County Democrat, Senatobia, Mississippi. It's a classified ad. It says, two wedding dresses and veal for sale. Very reasonable. It sounds like Willard Scott had to cancel a party.
Unbelievably funny that we're... Unbelievably...
Pardon me.
Pardon me.
That's very, very distracting.
We're just talking. We're just talking over here.
Well, you can visit quietly with each other, but only during the commercial. And please, put out those cigarettes. Very bad for you.
Dave always lets us smoke.
Oh, I find that very hard to believe. You know, when Live at 5 across the hall here has a substitute anchor person,
Live at 5.
They behave very properly.
Yeah, right.
All right, okay, who threw that? Just fine. Now we can stop the whole tape and we'll do the segment over again, and it would serve you all right. We'll just stay here a little bit later.
What is the noise?
I tried my best, Dave, but I just can't control those animals.
Well, no, Regis, don't be too hard on yourself. It takes a while to get the hang of this kind of thing.
Ah, Dave, I don't understand. You know, it's usually nice and quiet in here. Look how nice they are right now. Yeah. When you come in here and tell jokes, everybody listens.
Yeah. Thanks, Regis. Thanks so much for helping us out.
I had no idea hosting a show was this
hard.
Well,
that's all right. Don't worry, Regis.
Right back.
Very discouraged, Dave. I really am very discouraged.
Morning four. So far.
Letter number five. Dear Dave, we've got some GE washers
in our dorm for laundry. Well, I've lost about $5 in those machines because they're always breaking. Can you help me get my money or something? Help me, Steve Killian, Wake Forest University. Well, Steve, thank you. Thank you very much for your letter and for thinking about me. But, you know, I'm afraid I really can't help you. Those machines there in your dorm, they get a lot of use and abuse, and they're bound to break down now and then. And I suggest what you do is contact your dorm maintenance department. But again, thank you for writing in.
Hold it. Wait a second.
Yes, Paul?
Dave, what's the matter with you? Don't you have any backbone? General Electric, the people who run this network, ripped this kid off. They took this kid for $5.
Wow.
And there's no telling how many other intelligent college students they've stolen from. I'm not taking this crap anymore. I'm fed up with this place.
Now, Paul, wait a minute. What exactly are you trying to say?
What am I trying to say?
Yes.
I'm saying, let's trash this thing.
Oh, no, Paul, I don't see. Oh, no. It's just, I hate. Yes.
We just got a call from Wake Forest University.
Oh, they just got a call from Wake Forest.
What?
Yes, Al.
They have no Steve Killian enrolled there.
What?
Wait a minute. In fact, they say the washing machines are from West Germany.
Well, so what about the letter, Hal?
Probably a hoax. Paul.
See, that's Paul? It. The letter was a hoax. It was just a joke.
Well, goodness sake. I feel kind of silly. Leave it to me to overreact. Yeah. You know, isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
Sorry about this mess.
Well, yeah.
Well, you know, I think at least we learned something.
We did. We learned something. What did we learn?
We learned
a little something.
Well, I think we learned that you should wait until you have your facts straight before you trash a TV studio.
That's right. So we did.
I think it
has a happy ending after all.
Yeah.
That's viewer mail, more or less. We'll be right back here, folks. Letter number two. Dear Dave, what is it like being famous? Not knowingly, Liz Lowe's Long Branch, New Jersey. Well, Liz, you know, people imagine that it's very glamorous, but always being recognized actually can be kind of a nuisance. In fact, whenever I go into public, I have to wear this disguise here. This is the only way people will leave me alone, and then I can pretty much go anywhere I want. Just walking around like that, it's not a problem for me.
I just put on
this simple little disguise.
Come
here,
on,
mask,
now. Wait a second.
Not a
what
problem
the?
At all.
What the hell is going on with this?
What's the matter, Paul?
Have I worked on this show for 6 years just to be insulted like this?
It's just a joke. Will you relax?
Come on.
It's only a joke. It's a little cardboard cutout. I put it on my face.
Yeah.
Only a joke. We all enjoyed it. I'm sorry you're miffed, but it's just a joke.
Okay.
So why don't you just relax?
All right. You relax. Okay.
Letter number three.
You relax.
What?
Because I'm out of here. I'm out of here. You relax. Enough. You know, with a wire comes out of your shirt in the middle of a show.
That could be important.
You're
you got a
walking,
wire coming out of your
doing
shirt.
Wait a
minute.
Show
wait a minute, Paul.
A reunion and
I'll
sunny,
handle
you
this.
Learn
hold
all
Paul.
The old hits.
Wait a minute, Paul.
That
wait
they
a
have.
Second. I know how to handle this. Paul, look. Look, Paul. Rice Krispies squares.
What?
Rice Krispies squares, Paul. Freshly baked. There they are.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Just this once, though.
Okay.
Don't let it happen.
Right. Thanks, Paul. Boy, there's a joke we never get tired of, huh?
I want to sing on her show before, you know.
What letter are we up to now? Is it three or four?